Daly and Mrs. Turner, two sisters, spent their first days at the Blackball School. That was 75 years ago. At about 9:15, the bus from town arrives, as it does every morning. Slowly and quietly, the town comes to life. Down on the seat by the hall, Taggy sits and remembers.
In 1995, when I first went to school at Magna, 1895, down where the Masonic Hall is now, there was a school then, only one room. And Mr. Harrison was the headmaster. A little while after, they got a what there's now and then as a pupil teacher. There was no training colleges. They get a what they call it, a pupil teacher, and they were being taught from the headmaster for a certain time. That's how they evolved to be teachers.
In 1895, Taggy sat in this classroom. That was 75 years ago. When the Blackball School first opened on the 4th of March 1895 with a roll of 24 pupils, Blackball was in a period of transition from a gold mining settlement to that of a coal mining township. From that period until the present day, the role of the Blackball School has been governed by the national demand for coal. In 1914, when over 1,000 tons of coal was being produced daily, the school roll was over 200 pupils. This year of 1970, the Blackball School celebrates its 75th jubilee. The roll today stands at 37 pupils and 3 teachers, Diane Chapman, Francie Driscoll, and the headmaster, John Faulkner. Today there is no demand for Blackball coal. Today there is no Blackball coal. The population of the town, as well as the population of the school, has decreased greatly. On the 24th of September, 1964, the Blackball mine was sealed off and closed. Many thought it was the end for Blackball, and that within time it would be nothing but a memory. But they were wrong. Thank you. 1931, the old Blackball School was closed and the new one opened. In 1951, the first school reunion was held. Francie Driscoll has taught at the Blackball School for the last 23 years. Over half of those returning for the Jubilee began school under Mrs. Driscoll. sad but certain fact that the black ball of old is now dead and departed, and remains only in our fondest memories. But a town is not buildings, industry, and schools alone. A town is first and foremost people. And even if these people are scattered far and wide, the unique spirit of comradeship, cooperation, and sincerity, which has become an integral part of its citizens, will never die. And neither shall the town.